हेलो सेमेस्टर 4 पेपर 10 लाइफस्टाइल एंड न्यूट्रिशन यूनिट 3 बैलेंस्ड प्रोटीन डाइट सोर्सेज प्रिपरेशन सब्स्टिट्यूशंस। प्रोटीन क्या है, हम लोग बहुत शुरुआत से इसको पढ़ते आए हैं। उसके क्या उसमें है, एमिनो एसिड है, क्या है, कितनी तरह के हैं और क्या स्ट्रक्चर है, कितने मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं, एवरीथिंग उसके बारे में हम लोग जानते आए हैं। बट नॉट इन ब्रीफ, एक शॉर्ट हम लोग उसके बारे में जानेंगे और उसके बाद बैलेंस प्रोटीन डाइट के बाद। द वर्ड प्रोटीन कम्स फ्रॉम अ ग्रीक वर्ड मीनिंग प्राइमरी और होल्डिंग फर्स्ट प्लेस विच इज़ एन अप्रोप्रिएट नेम फॉर एन एसेंशियल लाइफ फॉर्मिंग एंड लाइफ सस्टेनिंग सब्सटेंस ऑफ ऑल ऑर्गेनिज्म। प्रोटीन मेक अप द मेजर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑल लिविंग सेल्स एंड फॉर्म मोस्ट ऑफ द ड्राई वेट ऑफ द बॉडी सेल्स। प्रोटीन इज द मोस्ट अबंडेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ द बॉडी। Proteins are the building blocks of life. Every cell in the human body contains proteins. The basic structure of protein is a chain of amino acids. There are thousands of different specific proteins in the body, each having a unique structure and function. For the reason, the word protein implies not one but a large group of complex compounds. Proteins are present in all living tissues, both animal and plant. They are essential to life because vital parts of the nucleus and protoplasts of every cell are protein. Now, ये तो था हमारा introduction about protein. Protein का composition देखेंगे. Proteins are very large compounds. Protein like carbohydrates and fats contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. In addition, protein contain about 16% nitrogen, which is their unique features and distinguishes them from carbohydrates and fats. Some proteins also contain sulfur, iron, phosphorus and cobalt. Proteins are more complex than fats and carbohydrates as the size of molecule enlarge and there is a great variation in the units which it is formed. Now, ये तो था composition of protein. Now, अब हम देखेंगे इसमें structure and classification. Structure and classification of protein. On hydrolysis of large molecules of proteins gives our smaller units of protein are called amino acids. There are 20 amino acids. They are classified as essential and non-essential amino acids. Essential amino acids are not synthesized in the body in an adequate quantity. Therefore, they have to be supplied through food daily. Non-essential amino acids are synthesized in the body using carbon, skeleton and amino group from other amino acid. On the basis of chemical composition, protein is classified as simple protein, conjugated protein, derived protein. On hydrolysis, simple protein gives amino acid, while conjugated protein gives a protein and non-protein fraction. On the basis of presence of essential and non-essential amino acids, proteins are classified as complete protein, partially incomplete and incomplete proteins. Proteins has many functions. According to हमारी body की क्या requirement है उन सबको देखते हुए इनकी कुछ मात्रा भी निर्धारित रहती है, कुछ amount जो एक adequate amount में every person को लेना होता है. Now we are seeing function of proteins. Number one is growth. ये बहुत deep में हम लोग नहीं जाएंगे, बहुत brief में इसको नहीं देखेंगे, just हम लोग अभी तक ये देखते आए, एक just एक as a knowledge और एक as a recall करने के लिए इसके functions हम लोग देखते हैं. Number one is most important function जो है protein का growth. Everybody knows कि without protein जो हमारा एक एक cell इससे बना हुआ है, तो growth के लिए protein बहुत ज़रूरी होता है. Every living cell of our body contains protein and is required for growth and maintenance of every cell in our body. Now next is energy supply. Protein is the last source that the body taps for energy. Each gram of food protein yield 4 calories to the body. Now next is regulatory function. Hemoglobin, a protein and iron complex, ensure the smooth running of respiratory cycle by being the vital oxygen carriers in the red blood cells. The next function, transport of nutrients. Due to their amphoteric nature, proteins are ideal carriers of nutrients across cell membrane. And next is special function of amino acids. Almost all amino acids have some unique function in the body. वो हम लोगों ने particular इसको देखा था. Now sources of protein. Animal sources are complete proteins such as meat, egg, poultry, fish, and they are good protein food in both quality and quantity. Milk is a valuable source of protein because although it does not contain a large quantity of protein, the quality is excellent. Gelatin, a derived protein, is an exception since it contains free limiting amino acids and hence is a poor source. Good sources of plant proteins are legumes, pulses, nuts and oilseeds, but their quality is poorer than that of the flesh food listed here. Now, however, complementing two plant sources or combining an animal and a vegetable source is one meal increases the nutritional value of the meal. All vegetable and fruits are a poor source of protein. So, ओवरऑल एनिमल सोर्सेज ऑफ जो फूड होता है, जो फूड एनिमल सोर्सेज से मिलते हैं, उनमें प्रोटीन बहुत अच्छी मात्रा में पाई जाती है. और वेजिटेरियन के लिए पल्सेस हैं, सीड्स हैं और ऑयल सीड्स हैं और नट्स हैं, मिल्क है, ये उनको प्रोटीन बहुत अच्छी मात्रा में देता है.